All right, time for us now to put a wrap on week number 4 in the WIAA football season. It is brought to us by Supercharge Foods, along with Eric Rogers. I am Rich Reynolds, and let's go ahead and start breaking down what happened in the Big 8. We finally had one of those great weather nights. You know, it felt kind of like fall. Yeah, and was good hitting weather. We saw some good hitting. We saw Verona, Madison West, and I think what we got to see was a pretty good Verona team that right now is still just one game away from being at the top of the Big 8 conference.
They both came into that game kind of in a position to either even the records between the two teams, or Verona was going to pull away a little bit. That's what we ended up seeing after that win. Some good offense on both sides, but in the end, it's just too much roster, too much talent on Verona. And they are a couple wins now away from clinching a playoff spot. And we're already talking about that.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we're, you know, 4 weeks into the season, only 5 weeks to go. You know, by the time we're talking next week, we're talking second half of the season then already. So that's already passed us by. I think Verona's definitely a playoff team. Another team in the Big 8 that I think is definitely going to be a playoff team after stubbing their toe in week one is the Sun Prairie Cardinals. And they put a hurt on Janesville, Craig.
They did, and for Janesville Craig, that means their first blemish on the record. And you know, you come in now 3-1, and you know, you look at that game and just say, hey, we're gonna lose one somewhere probably. So it's tough to go undefeated, especially in the Big 8 here. So all conference games matter, and here they are, you know, now one loss on the record there. But Sun Prairie, I mean, the Cardinals scored 3 rushing touchdowns, 3 passing touchdowns. Oh yeah, and they also took a fumble in for a touchdown.
Yeah, that's a really good football team that lost to Madison Memorial week one. Kind of a shocker. Talk about shockers. Memorial does it again.
Yeah, nice transition. All
yeah, right. They go to Middleton. They pull off the stunning upset. They're down 10 in the fourth quarter. They come back, Hail Mary to win it to end the football game. Wow, Madison Memorial is 4-0 and all alone at the top of the conference.
Well, we saw Dryden Schaefer, the receiver on that play, in our first football broadcast of the season, and he was definitely, I think, underappreciated, but definitely wasn't on the radar for a lot of people. And he came in, caught obviously that big pass to get the win, and it's a 30-27 win for Memorial, who, you know, in Middleton, I think they've kind of come across a couple of tough games where they didn't maybe expect to lose that game, and you know, it's tough to lose on a last play like that. And now they are 2-2. So you start thinking about which direction are they going to go. They have a tough sledding ahead a little bit.
Yeah, Middleton's 2-2. They still have Sun Prairie left. They still have Verona left on their schedule. So, I mean, they got some tough games coming up, do the Cardinals, but probably still a playoff team, although they've been snake bitten a couple of times so far this season. So we turn our attention now. We go from the Big 8 over to the Badger North Conference, where still reigning supreme are the Wanakee Warriors. They remain undefeated in a, you know, a rivalry game every year with DeForest. It wasn't close once again. Wanakee has owned this rivalry recently.
They have, and it's tough to find new things to say about Wanakee because it's the same story. You know, it's another win. It's another big win. It's another 4-0 start for them. Again, you know, close to another playoff appearance. And we're looking at some of the scores here within the conference, and you know, you have you know, quite a few surprises. I mean, Reedsburg to be 3-1. I mean, you know, they're kind of one of those teams that's not necessarily always at the top of the conference, but they're definitely competing, and we think they're going to be a team to be reckoned with here. Mount Hoar Barneville gets a win. So some good, definitely, competition within the Badger North.
Yeah, Mount Hoar Barneville putting up big numbers against Beaver Dam. At Beaver Dam, that was pretty tough last year. They're 1-3 to start the season. But that Mount Hoar team, I mean, except for the blowout loss at Wanakee, they've looked really good.
They have. I'm just going to look at a couple of stats here. They came back from a loss to Wanakee, by the way, which is a surprisingly big loss to Wanakee. They come back, Ethan Post and Caden Lee, the receiver, they tagged up for 6 receptions, 268 yards, 3 touchdowns. Ethan Post, by the way, 471 total yards in that game.
Impressive indeed. We turn our attention finally to the Badger South Conference, and there we see the Watertown Goslings, a big win on the road at Monroe. Monroe, always one of those places that's really tough to play, but Watertown, a brand newcomer last year to the conference, goes in there in a tough spot and gets a big win.
Yeah, I'm not sure how much of that has to do with just a new team coming into a conference and, you know, some unfamiliarity, but you have, you know, your Stoughtons and your MGs at the top of the conference right now, but not too many people, I think, are talking about Watertown, what they've done. They beat, obviously, you know, Monroe, you know, moved to 3-1 in the conference, or overall 2-0 in the conference, and become another one of those teams that is at the top of the conference. So certainly the Goslings, something to watch out for. Watertown's quarterback, Ethan Pauley, 272 yards, 2 touchdowns. He did have 2 picks, so some things to clean up, but certainly there for the taking is the potential there for a better South Conference.
Absolutely. You know, you mentioned Stoughton. Stoughton goes on the road, wins at Milton. That's a hard place usually to win. If you've ever been down to one of those games, they're crazy down there. They love their team. They come out in droves, so a big win there for Stoughton. Also, MG undefeated. They blank Madison Edgewood, and we're going to get a chance to see the Silver Eagles this week.
We've got Fort at MG this week, so we'll see how that one goes. Fort's looking for their first win.
Yeah, and for MG, they're looking to stay undefeated and at the top of the Badger South Conference. So a few surprises along the way in week number four. Again, like when we talk next week, we're already going to be over halfway through the season.
Unbelievable. And then, of course, you're going to want to tune in because we've got playoff action this year as well.
Yeah, we are doing that. So that is exciting stuff. So, Eric, great stuff. Appreciate it as always. And that is your WIAA football report. It is presented by Supercharge Foods.